the end game. Your first vehicle, your first ministry, your dominant gift. You got only one book, and now you don't want to write any longer. Your first marriage. You thought that was the end game. Could it be that it was, see, there is no detours, only predetermined routes to get you to your destination, get you to your destiny. So could it be that God, the Ancient of Days, have already ran ahead of you and put these episodes in place because he knows. I said he knows. That the end game has always been the eternal. The eternal one.
Come on, man of God.
So you'll never get the eternal one until you go through the crushing. It's easy to go through the crushing on this level. See, this crushing,
that hurt.
No, it's not that it hurts. It looks too pleasurable. God wants me to crush something that I can consume. God said, I never intended for you to consume it. I intended for you to crush it. Come here, Abraham. I want you to crush your only son. Come here, Father God. I want you to crush your only son. Because what you thought was getting ready for consumption, God now is preparing you for crushing. So crushing becomes a man of new creation. God said, because I'm getting ready to do something new in your life. He says, I'm getting ready to bring you, amen, into a new company of people. He said, now, amen, consider not the former things, neither consider the things of old. He says, I'm getting ready, amen, to do a new thing. Before I bring you into this new thing, I got to allow the enemy to crush you. And so now grab a neighbor real good and say, neighbor, we have this treasure in earthen vessels. That the excellency of the power might be of God and not of us. We are troubled on every side. I am not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. We are persecuted, but not forsaken. We are cast down, but not destroyed. Grab your neighbor and say, neighbor, I reckon that the suffering of this present time is worthy to be compared with the glory that shall be revealed. God told me to tell somebody that our suffering and shame have produced enough spiritual strength. The enemy thought that our struggle and our suffering would cause us to scatter and cause us to flee. But he did not know that all of the pain was producing power, and all of the shame was sharpening and strengthening, amen, the supernatural. Grab a neighbor real good and shout, neighbor. I said, grab a neighbor real good and say, neighbor, I don't know what stage of life you might be currently on. Say, I don't know what stage of life you might be going through. You might be in seed form, and that's all right. You might be in the grape form, and that's all right. But God told me to tell you that this next stage is getting ready to release the eternal wine of your destiny. Get out of your seat and go find another neighbor, y'all, and tell them these words. Wine is on his way. Wine symbolizes the wealth of God. Wine symbolizes the abundance, the prosperity. Wine symbolizes the glory of God. Wine symbolizes new joy, new wealth, and new prosperity. Do me a favor, it's your neighbor. Sometimes God has to put his foot on your neck. Get somebody high five and say, sometimes God has to put his foot on your neck. And it seems like he's strangling you, but he's really giving you strength for your next move. He's giving you new joy. He's giving you a new praise. He's giving you a new confession. Do me a favor. Let me see the hands of every believer that you've been through the furnace of affliction. Y'all teasing me. You ain't been through nothing. Let me see the hands of every believer that can testify that I've had my share of lies, ups and downs. I've had my share of my heart being broken, stomped on, ridiculed. But tell your neighbor, shout neighbor, if I never had a problem, I wouldn't know God the solver. If I'd never been broke, I would have known him to be Jehovah Jireh. If I'd never been sick, I would have known him to be Jehovah Rapha. Tell your neighbor, after the crutches shall come the celebration. Get ready. I sense in the spirit Harvest Tabernacle. Get ready for celebration. 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 Why are you celebrating? Because I once was